Autonomy Day. We just finished up Autonomy Day. How many out there in the peanut gallery actually watched the entire thing? I did. Isn't that awesome? That was a very, very long program, clocking in at about 3 hours and 40 minutes. But dang, if my jaw wasn't wide open watching it almost the entire time. Yeah. Basically, my take from it is every other car manufacturer, if they are as behind as the rest of us think they are, which for the most part they are, is telling us that they are screwed for the short term and pretty far behind yet for the long term. In that Autonomy Day investor calling, or I don't know what else to call it. It was more like a giant press release. Elon and company talked about Tesla's strategy, and I should turn my fan down there. They talked about Tesla's strategy for full autonomous driving, and you know, just the outlook of it. Elon's, of course, we got to remember, this is Elon time, which means things are subject to change, and how long he says something's going to happen doesn't usually happen right on his schedule, but what do they call it? Forward-looking statements. He wants steering wheels and pedals gone from the cars within the next 2 years, if legislation and laws permit it. That's pretty darn good and very ambitious. Do I think they can pull it off? While I wouldn't say that I had my doubts, I didn't think that it would happen that quick, at least not until I picked up this Model X with AP2 and the full self-drive option. Once I got this thing and, initially it was okay. And then we got nav by autopilot with confirmation. I'm like, all right, he might just be able to pull this off. And then three or four days after I got nav by autopilot with confirmation, we got nav without confirmation. And then I'm like, holy crap. Yeah, they pulled this off. At least on the freeway, he is pulled off. I'd give it a good 90% of full self-drive on the freeway. 90%. There's still finishing touches, missed a few exits I was able to catch in time. Still needs to be able to read speed limit signs. I mean, heck, last night the car even notified me when I entered a construction zone. A little pop-up came up that said construction... popped up and disappeared so quickly, but it was something along the lines of construction zone detected or construction detected. So they are sure as heck pulling it off. Now Tesla does have a very unique position in that pretty much from the get-go, since the early Model S era, so 2012, 2013, they were already planning full self-drive way the heck back then. So they have had a really long time to start planning things out. Yeah, they had some setbacks, mainly when Mobileye and Tesla had their arguments, and Tesla said, you know what, F you, we'll just make our own. And that's when Autopilot 2 was born. Yeah, that was a setback a bit. But, you know, in the long run, that was probably the best thing, because that kind of forced Tesla's hand into designing the new full self-drive chip, or computer board, processor, whatever you want to call it, that is what's going in all new vehicles being built right now. Hold on a second. All new vehicles being built right now, and also going to be retrofitted into vehicles that paid for full self-drive options. So the hardware is already there. His neural net is already learning. And this is real-world mileage, not computer simulations, especially as Elon and company very, very strongly pointed out. You can run all the simulations you want, but there's always those niche cases out in the real world that you just don't account for until they actually happen. I mean, crazy stuff happens in the real world. I have seen it, folks. And the neural net is learning from all of this. Every little interaction, every interruption of autopilot by the driver, that all gets sent back to Tesla. They analyze it. Oh, hey, we could make better corrections here. And it's learning. I'm still on firmware 9. Release 2019.12. So for me, that was my first iteration that had the nav without confirmation. And I swear to you, this thing is learning. Spots where don't want to change lanes because we're going to have to be in this lane anyways. Now it would have moved me over and then moved me back, but I don't want that. I should probably turn off Mad Max. Let's put it to mild. Spots that Nav by Autopilot had trouble with when I first got it are already fixed. I can now navigate spots that I could not make before. I'm even able to go through freaking roundabouts. Most people can't make it through a roundabout without major F-ups. No, see, now this is one spot. This is a brand new road, and this touches on why other manufacturers with their HD maps and pre-recorded routes. No, you know what? I'm disengaging because it wants to put me way in the wrong lane. This is a pretty new intersection and interchange right here that we're coming up on. And it's completely bass-ackwards from the way it used to be. Problem being, and this is why Elon hates the HD map idea and says it's a bad idea. Because the car wanted to put us into the left lane. We would have just completely missed our exit. Because the map is out of date. And it can happen that quick. Fail. LiDAR. While LiDAR can be great in some circumstances, now I would love to see LiDAR also incorporated onto the cars. You cannot have too many sensors, but you can have too few. Now, I don't think the vision nav system and radar is too few, but I do think they would be better off having too many sensors than not enough, although I can see how it can bring the cost up. So potentially in the next generation, say full self-drive version 2, or what would be autopilot version 4, if you will, or hardware version 4. So just everything that Tesla's been able to do so far, they are so far ahead of the game. Now, you also take into consideration that, they also got the idea from Robotaxi coming out next year. People are also wondering why they went with Robotaxi instead of Tesla Taxi. Probably because there is a company out there already called Tesla Taxi, and Tesla would have to then secure the trademark or the rights to the name from that company, which will cost them more money. So they just went with Robotaxi. And since Tesla Taxi is already a trademark name, Robotaxi takes that name away from all the other possible companies. So not only will Tesla eventually have Robotaxis based initially on the Model 3 out on the road, their plans next year, of course, laws and legislation permitting. People who own Model 3s and Model Ys, and hopefully eventually Model S's and X's, will be able to also take advantage of that, meaning you get to rent out your car. You can drive for quote-unquote Lyft and Uber without actually driving for Lyft and Uber. Well, obviously it's Tesla's own system, But, well, you're at work. You can send your car off to work. Why should it be sitting in the parking lot somewhere doing who knows what? Actually, we do know what. Sitting in a parking lot somewhere. When it could be off driving around and making you some little bit of do-re-mi on the side. Your car not only saves you money when you drive it, it also makes you money when you're not. I mean, I don't know how much better that can get. And the disappearing steering wheels and pedals. I mean, I think that's going to take a little longer than Elon's planning or plans for, just because of the comfort factor. And then you still have the ditch case scenarios. I suppose they could have some sort of touch screen or video game joypad you could pull out to do the fine tuning. Example. Driving off a road. Let's see. Nav by autopilot without confirmation. Took the right exit this time. This is an older exit. Maps are correct for this one. But, I mean, think of driving... say you're going to a music festival and you got to park on the grass in some field somewhere. How is full self-drive going to really know what is the proper place to park or not? Or say you're going to tow a trailer. Got to back up just right to get that ball under the trailer hitch. So I think we're still a ways away, at least without something like a joypad or a Joy-Con to be able to do those fine-tuned controls. To be completely... I mean, I'd get rid of a steering wheel if I had some sort of backup control that I could pull out in those niche cases. Or at the very, very least, and I'm not a fan of that. Oh, nav by autopilot has reached its end. Time for me to take over. So, I mean, you could do touchscreen nav. I don't see that working quite like how people would want. But, I mean, it's a stepping stone. It's a start. Since I got a steering wheel, I'm keeping my steering wheel. You never know. Plus, sometimes you just enjoy driving. Spirited drive, or if you want to go to a track. How are you going to do a track and go racing without a steering wheel? It takes all the fun out of it. So, I mean, at least keep the steering wheel optional, or at least make it removable. So, you know, pop it on, take off the steering wheel, pop on just an airbag, you know, airbag housing or something. Okay, going to the track. Okay, take off the airbag housing, pop my steering wheel and pedals back on. You know, something along those lines. But either way, I was so impressed. What are your thoughts? I mean, come on. I know everybody's thinking something different here. And right now I'm hearing everything going each way. I'm hearing it from people saying, oh, Tesla just slaughtered every other manufacturer. And at the same time, I'm also hearing it, oh my God, Tesla's not even going to make it through the end of the 2019. I mean, nobody really knows at this point. I think Tesla is, if they can get their company internals worked out, meaning their company internal communications, work on their delivery and service side of things. Because service, let's all face it, service has gone so far downhill. Personally, I'm trying to keep it as much as possible with our ranger, our local ranger. Jacob, you're awesome. And I hear good things about our other Wisconsin ranger, Chris. But I'm sorry, Chris, I don't think I've met you yet. But Jacob is the absolute awesomest. And Tesla, if you want to bring your service standards back to how they were when you first came out with the S, the service that blew everybody away, talk with Jacob. He will get you back there. I mean, he provides the top-notch service that you don't see at the service centers anymore. But Tesla's got to fix their service, and they've got to fix vehicle deliveries. And, of course, maybe, you know, making sure everything's right from the get-go. If they can get that done, then they are set. But if they can't get their service and communication back on track, that's it. That would be, I think, their downfall. So, like, subscribe, share. If you don't like the video, thumbs down. If you do like it, thumbs up. And let me know what your opinions are. in the description box or in the comment section below. Let me know what your thoughts on the whole Autonomy Day thing were. What do you guys think of the full self-drive and where it's at now compared to when it's finished, or how close you guys think it's finished? But like I said, from what I see right now, freeway driving is about 90% complete. Just needs some refinement. And city drive, that's coming very, very soon. So see you guys all next video. Adios.